Welcome all. In today's session, we will be doing 3-bit full subtractor. I am not drawing a 4-bit full subtractor, 3-bit full subtractor. Now, in 3-bit full subtractor, what happens? 3-bit parallel subtractor we can take. Similar to a ripple carry adder, 3-bit parallel subtractor. Now, when you take a 3-bit parallel subtractor, you will have two inputs, A, 3 bits, right? So it is A0, A1, A2. Let me write it as A of 0, A of 1 and A of 2. A of 1 and A of 2. Now B also I can write it in the similar format. B of 0, B of 1 and B of 2. Only one input we will be having to a full subtractor scene and one output we will get, which is of single bit size. Sum is also again 3 bit in size. So sum will again be, so sum will be similar to this S of 2, S of 1 and S of 2, S of 1 and S of 0. I will get a sum similar to this. Okay. Now this is in a ripple carry adder, you can call this as a sum. In a parallel subtractor, instead of calling it as the sum, we will call it as difference. And instead of calling it as carry, we will call it as borrow. So this one A, B I have taken. So instead of carry in this one, this variable, let us make it as borrow. So instead of C in, B in I will write. So this is borrow in is equal to, already the variable B I've used, so I'll write BB of 0. So I'll get one output. It is not S of 0, I told we'll get the difference. Again A of 1, B of 1. So this will not be S of 1, this will be D of 1, difference of 1. Then I have another one, so this will be, instead of S, it will be the difference. Now I also have a carry over, borrow out. So borrow out is over here. So what will that borrow out be equal to? Borrow out will be equal to B of 4. Borrow out is equal to BB of 4. So here I'll be having B in, BB of 0. Output will be BB of 1 and difference. So it is A of 1, B of 1, BB of 1. Difference D of 1 and BB of 2. So A of 2, B of 2 and BB of 2 will be the input. I'll get the difference and the borrow. So now this 3-bit parallel subtractor, let us implement using Verilog. Okay. So now we'll come over here. Now what I detail, what is the thing we are going to do? 3-bit parallel subtractor. Module ripple subtractor. What is your output? Output is difference and it is borrow out. A comma B comma C is okay. Now what are the inputs? Generally we will write the input as input A0, A1, A2, A3. We used to write like this. Now this type of inputs is known as scalar inputs. Now instead of using scalar, I've used a vector over here. Input 3 down to 0, A comma B, which represents a vector format. Then output sum. There is one more input B and there is one output B out. There are intermediate signals which will be declared. So that, let us write it as wire. So what will be the intermediate signal? I see it is BB of 4. So 4 to 0. So this will be equal to 4 down to 0 BB. This is done. Now what I get over here, if I see, whatever I get over here, now what I get over here, this is one full subtractor, this is one full subtractor, this is one full subtractor. Let me write the program for full subtractor also. So this coding we can write in structural model or gate level model we are writing. We are writing this code in structural model or gate level model. So what is the first one? I have a full subtractor. Let me label it as G1. What is the output of the full subtractor? Come back over here. So the output of subtractor is D of 0, BB of 1, which is a wire. So the output of the full subtractor is D of 0, BB of 1. What is the input of the full subtractor? A of 0, comma, B of 0 and B in. B in is also equal to BB. So I can either write B in or I can write BB of 0. Both will work. Next one, what is the next one? The next one, again, I have a full subtractor. So the next one is a full subtractor again. The gate is G2. So D0, BB of D, this output will be D1. And this will be equal to D2. And this will be equal to A2. This will be equal to B2. And here it will be equal to BB of 2. So this BB of 2, BB of. So this will be equal to, let us see what it is. So here I have BB of 0. BB of 1 is the input. BB of 2 is the output. So here it is BB of 1 is the input. BB of 2 is the output. So this was actually A1, B1 and B2 since it is the second full subtractor. Now the third thing is the third full subtractor. There is a third gate. So what is the third full subtractor? Gate 3. So third full subtractor will be G2 will be the difference. BB3 will be the output. So this will be A2 is the input. And here it is B2 is the input. And BB2 is the input. So if I can see over here. So A2 is the input, B2 is the input, BB2. From the previous circuit, I am getting BB2 as the input. Then D of 3 is the output, B of D of 2. Actually, this should be D of 2 is the output and B of 2 is BB of D of 2. So this will be BB of 2. So this is the output what we have. Just you can keep retain any names. I am keeping the name so that it is easy for you. Difference of 0, difference of 1, difference of 2, BB of 1, BB of 2, BB of 3, BB of 0, BB of 1, BB of 2. So this is correct. So D2, so here BB of 3 will be the output. This is the thing. Then what I have to write? Assign Cout is equal to BB of 3 because I want the output in terms of C out. The end module. That's all is our full subtractor. 4-bit ripple subtractor. Parallel subtractor we can take. Now we have this full subtractor. Where is the program for this full subtractor? This is the main module which I've written. So I have to write the code for full subtractor. Then only that code will be invoked during simulation over here. So for that, let me write the code for full subtractor. Module, full subtractor. So what can be the inputs to the full subtractor? The output of the full subtractor can be difference, comma, borrow. And what is the input to the full subtractor I'll have? Input to the full subtractor I can have. This will be B out. What will be the input to the subtractor I can have? A, comma, B, comma. B in, borrow input. So let me write it as borrow input. These are the inputs to the full subtractor. You can also implement a full subtractor using two half subtractors. Now, first let me finish input this one. I have input. Input will be A comma B comma B in. Then I have the output. Output will be equal to difference and B out are the two outputs. Now, if you write using full subtractor using two half subtractors, first I should write half subtractor gate 1, write the code over here which I'm not writing, then half subtractor G2, and you can write the code over here, then it will be end module as it is. After this, again, where is the code for half subtractor? We don't have the code for half subtractor, right? So we have to write again the code for half subtractor. So module half subtractor, and write the code for half subtractor over here, end module. This is invoking half subtractor inside full subtractor. Full subtractor is instantiated in the parallel subtractor. So now let us not go for this part. I will write full subtractor module using, you can write using any of the modeling styles. I will write using data flow model assign. So what is your difference? According to us, difference is equal to A XOR B XOR C. And this is the code, this is the expression for difference. And what is the expression for borrow? Borrow out in full subtractor will be equal to, what is the expression for borrow out in full subtractor? Which it is A bar and B or again it is A bar and Q. A bar and AB so A bar B bean. What is the input? It is bean. Then it is A, B, B, C, A bar. So next it is B and bean. B and bean. So this is the expression for the borrow. It is similar to our full adder expression. What was the full adder expression? The full adder expression was A and B or B and C or A and C. So here I have written A bar B, B and B. It's the same thing. So this is what we have for ripple subtractor, parallel subtractor. Now we have to write the test bench for parallel subtractor. So now when we write the test bench for parallel subtractor, it is module. So RS underscore test, you can write anything. So what I should write? All inputs will be declared as wires. All outputs will be declared. All inputs will be declared as registers. All outputs will be declared as wires. So all inputs will be declared as registers. All outputs should be declared as wire. This whatever you see on the design.sv, this is what is enough for our program. So this is the main module and the sub module in gate level modeling style. But to verify whether this design is working correctly, we are going to write this subtractor test bench. This test bench is going to apply this test cases on the main module and check whether it is working correctly. So that is why we need the test bench. So all input should be declared as registers. All output should be declared as wire. So this will also be a wire. So this is done. Now what we have to do? We have to initialize. So initial begin. So what is our aim? 4-bit. Here I have taken a 3-bit subtractor. So 3-bit means A is equal to 3 tick B 0 0 0. B is equal to 3 tick B 0 0 0. You can write any test cases. I am writing only two examples. Hash This will be at zero time unit, and after some time, say after 5 time units, hash 5. So let me for every time your carry input will, I mean your borrow input will be equal to 0. Borrowing should always be equal to 0 because we are discussing about parallel subtractor. Now 0001. So let me take A is equal to 1 minus 0. So again, let me write once again this one, this X. So let me make this as 5. So let me make this as 1111. So end. And so next again initial. So this I'm writing for printing dollar monitor. So what are we going to print? Dollar time. So A is equal to percentage B. B is equal to percentage B. B in is equal to percentage B. Anyhow, I don't want to see B in as of now. I'll go for A, B, and I'll see the difference. Difference is equal to percentage B and borrow out, BB out, I guess. What is borrow out? B out. Borrow out is equal to percentage B. So this much only I want to see. So the first one is A, the second one is B. I'm not seeing B in. So let me make this as 2 down to 0 because it is only a 3-bit full adder. Since it's a 3-bit full subtractor, so this vector will be 2 down to 0. 2, 1 and 0. The third one is not required. That is why I've removed it. Okay. So A, B, difference, A, B, difference, B in, B out. So here I have A, B, difference, B in, B out. A, B, difference, B in I am not printing. I am only printing the difference and B out. If you want, you can even print the B in also. So let me check this end module. So this I have done. Now I want to check whether this coding is working. So let me run it. It is telling select a valid simulator. Now go to tools and simulators. There are so many simulators over here. I am using Mentor Questa simulator. You can even select Cadence also. There are other simulators also. So Icarus Verilog is also one simulator. For easy purpose, I am selecting Mentor Questa. You can also select Cadence. So I gave run. So there are some errors. Undefined variable. So in design SV.7, there is an undefined variable seen. Line number 17. A XOR, B XOR. This is not seen. This should have been bean. There are so many errors. So 11. Again in design SV2 second line. So this should have been B. So still I can see there is one error. So where is the error? In 18, near ampersand, line number 18, B out is equal to ए एंड बी और ए बार एंड बी और E and B or E. There's nothing else. There will be a simple error which we has to be debugged. That's all. So what I'll do, I'll put a not of A. A bar is not of A. So I can do it like this also. Maybe that is the error, syntax error only it is. So not of A. So now it is, this is correct. Now what is happening? A is 0, 0, 0, it is giving correctly. A is 0, B is 0, but it is not printing D. If it is not printing D, this value is not available over here. The design value is not available in the test bench. Why? It is because we didn't instantiate the main module in the test bench. So always you should instantiate the main module in the test bench. So if you don't instantiate the main module in the test bench, you will not be able to see the output. That is why you are getting Z, which means high impedance. We don't have any values over there. I have instantiated now. So it is telling, when A is 0, B is 0, difference will be 0, borrow out is 0, correct. Now when A is 0, 0, 1, B is 0, 0, 0, the difference is 1, no borrow out. Now when A is 0, 0, 1 and B is 1, 1, 1, the difference is 0, 1, 0 and borrow out is 1. You have to check this one, whether it is correct, whether we have got it correctly. Check it out. So this is with respect to 4-bit full sub, 3-bit full subtractor. Now, how do I implement a parallel adder for subtractor? Now, or else, how do you implement a parallel adder performing subtraction? I have an adder circuit, but it is performing subtraction. If I want to implement a subtractor from an adder circuit, so what happens? This is actually seen. For an adder, correct. This is seen. This we are going to take it as, we have taken it as C of 0. So all this will be S of 0. I'm just replacing this to the parallel adder. So this will be S of 1 and this is our S of 2. What is this? This was our C out, right? So this is C out and this is C out 3. Now what circuit is this? This is nothing but a parallel adder. You know it. A, B, C in C of 0. Here we'll get the output as C of 1. It goes on like that. Okay. Now I have to, so this like this will be nothing but a full adder. So this, let me label it as full adder 0 and full adder 0, full adder 1 and full adder. So full adder 0, this will be full adder 1, this will be full adder 2. Now this is a 3-bit full adder, 3-bit triple carry adder. Now how do I perform subtraction using ripple carry adder? Now to perform subtraction using ripple carry adder, I can either use 1's complement method or the 2's complement method. Now what is 2's complement and 1's complement, I'll be telling now. Before that, let us see how the circuit will get modified. So when you're performing that operation, what happens? I will have a NOT gate over here. Whatever input I'm giving to B, any one of the inputs will be complemented, any of the input. So we'll take B. I'm telling why I've taken B only, I will show you. So this is getting complemented. This is getting complemented, right? So this is getting complemented. Now 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. 0, NOT gate. So, okay, one sec, hold on. So what happens when I put a complement, when I put a NOT gate over here? So actually I have to, I'll not, you'll not be able to see the logic, but I'll just show this thing. So you can put the NOT gate over here. What happens when you put a NOT gate over here and this Cin is there, right? So this Cin value I will make it to 1. Cin is equal to, Cin is equal to 1. So when I put a NOT gate and make Cin is equal to 1, how will that work? That is what we are doing. How will it work? So I told we'll put a NOT gate, which will complement the inputs. Then I'll give the input. So this is how we are going to do. What is this input actually? This input according to us, what is this input? This input according to us is B of 1, right? B of 0. So now what happens? I'm going to put a NOT gate. So when I put a NOT gate, if I give a 0 over here, then only this becomes 1. 0 plus 1 plus 0 will be equal to 1. If I put a 1, NOT of 1, this is 1. So what goes as the input? 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. So that is why the output is 0. Now again here also we have to put a NOT gate. So let me remove this and put a NOT gate over here. Again, I'm going to put a NOT gate over here. This is for 3-bit what I'm showing. It can be reflected for N-bit also. So what is this? This is B of 1 and this becomes B of 0. B of 2. All the other things will change. Now how this circuit will modify your adder to a subtractor circuit. How was your adder getting modified to a subtractor? So let us see what has happened. Now what has happened? A0, it is actually A of 0 because I put in brackets. A1 and A2 is there. It is LSB. This one will be the LSB. This one will be the MSB. So it is A2, A1, A0. And I have B2, B1, B1 and B0. Now when you are performing addition, what happens in 2's complement method? Let me take one example. So 5 minus 3. What is the binary value for 5? Binary value for 5 is 1, 0, 1. What is the binary value for 3? Binary value for 3 is 0, 1, 1. Now, when I convert it into 2's complement, this 5 minus 3 is also equivalent to 5 plus of minus 3 according to your decimal notation. So it is 5 5 plus of minus 3, which is clearly telling that we can perform addition using, you can perform subtraction using adders. So 5 is not changing. 5 is retained as it is. So what is the value of 5? 101 in binary. But what has happened to 3? It is minus of 3. That means we have to write the 2's complement value of 3. Now what is the 2's complement value of 3? 0, 1, 1. If I complement and write it, so this will change to 1, 0, 0. This is known as 1's complement. If you just convert it and write, this is known as 1's complement. But what about 2's complement? In 2's complement, what happens? If I add 1 to 1's complement, if I add 1 to 1's complement, so what is the 1's complement of 3? 1, 0, 0. If it is 1, 0, 0 plus 1. 1, 0, 0 plus 1 is what? 1, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0, 1. This becomes a 2's complement number. So how did I get the 2's complement number? When I take the negative number, any number, negative number, if I convert the 1's to 0's and 0's to 1's, I'll get a 1's complement, that is direct complement. To the 1's complement number, if I add another 1, I will get a 2's complement number. So this is the 2's complement number. So now what happens here? 2's complement number of minus 3 will be 101. Now 2's complement of minus 3 is 101. Now the next thing what we have to do, we have to add 5 plus minus 3. So what will be 5 plus minus 3? 5 is 101. And what was our minus 3? 2's complement of our minus 3. 2's complement of our minus 3 was 101. And now when you add, what happens to this number? Now when you're adding. So now when you're adding, 1 plus 1 will be, 1 plus 1 will be 0, 1 carry. So this will be equal to 1. And this 1 plus 1 will be a 0. Right, this is the solution. And I'll have a carry out of 1. Now, whenever you're performing addition of negative numbers using 2's complement, you have to ignore this carry. So, which is the carry we have? We have this carry. We are going to ignore this carry. We are going to ignore the carry. So, what happens to the solution? It is 0, 1, 0. Now what is 0, 1, 0, which is equal to nothing but 2 in binary. It is equal to base 2 in binary. So now this is a full adder architecture which I have shown. 3-bit full adder architecture, parallel adder architecture. Now let us see how this is working. Now what happened? 1's complement is what? 1's complement of, which one did you take? Minus 3. So here, let us take A is equal to 5. Suppose if I take A is equal to 5, B is equal to minus 3. So B is equal to minus 3, what did we do? We took the 2's complement. For that, what did we do? First, we took the 1's complement of B. So first, what did we do? We took the 1's complement of B. That means, whatever B is there, if you can see in the figure, we have to give it to a NOT gate. We gave it to the NOT gate. Then what did we do? We did the 2's complement. So what does 2's complement mean? 1, 0, 0, 0. 1's complement plus 1. Plus 1, how will we add? Here we have Cin is equal to 0. Can you see? The Cin was 0 for a normal parallel adder. But to implement 4-bit or 3-bit subtraction using parallel adder, Cin should be compulsorily made 1 because this is 2's complement. 1's complement is NOT gate plus 1 is equal to 2's complement. Now what was your input? What was your A value? A was 5, which is 1, 0, 1. What was your B value? B value was 3.
So what is your 3, 0, 1 and 1? So what should be your sum? So now we'll feed the values. When you feed the values, A of 0 is initially, let me keep everything 0. So whenever we are implementing parallel subtractor using parallel adder, we have to make Cin is equal to C0 is equal to 1. Then if you can see, 5 is 101, which means this last bit is A0. Next bit is A1. So last bit is A0. Next bit is A1. Next bit is A2. Similarly, B0 will be equal to 1. B1 will be equal to 1. B2 will be equal to 0. It is 0, 1, 1 downwards. Now, what is the solution? What we got? A solution is, if you can see, it is 0, 1, 0. So 0, 1, 0 with C out is equal to 1. So this is how we are going to implement 4-bit full subtractor or 4-bit parallel subtractor using parallel adder. Here I've depicted for 3-bit. You can do it for n bit. The next thing what we are going to do is parallel adder and subtractor. A circuit which can perform both parallel adder and subtraction. Again, I'll take an example of 3-bit. You can do it as n bit also. Parallel adder, adder and subtractor circuit, which I've taken, which we are performing for 3-bit. You can take it for n bit. Now, parallel adder and subtractor circuit. Again, we are going to use full adder to perform both addition and subtraction as per a choice. So again, what we are going to do, we have to implement the same circuit. So we'll go for a 3-bit. 3-bit means, I told, we have to have a 3-bit full adder, 3 full adders. So I have 3 full adders over here and 3 inputs are there. So input, we are taking the inputs in vector notation so that it is easy for our coding. I'll take the inputs in vector notation. So this input, let me write it as A of 0. Next one is B of 0. Initially, let us keep all the values as 0. So this is Cin is equal to C of 0 is equal to 0. Initially, we'll keep it as 0. The next one is A1. Let me take this as A of 1. So A of 1 and make the value as 0. The next one, let me take it as B of 1 and make the value as 0. The next one is A of 2 and this one is B of 2. So these are the circuits which I've taken. Everything is equal to 0. Then output, let us keep the output. Here I need only sum of 0. Here I need only sum of 1. Here I need S of 2 and the other one is for C out. So this is S of 0. Here I have S of 0. Here I'll be having S of 1. Here I'll be having S of 2. And the other one is C out. So let me label this. So what is this equal to? Sum as well as difference. It will mean both sum and difference. So I will write S bar D so that it is understood for you of 0. So sum and difference it is. Either it can be sum of 0 or difference of 0. So this I will make it as S bar D of 1. Either it can be sum of 1 or difference of 1. The next one is S bar D of 2. So either it can be sum or it can be difference. And this one is, we know it is C out. C out or borrow out, whatever you take. C out or borrow out will be equal to C of 4, C of 3, because it is 4, 3 bit. C of, it can be either C of 3 or it can be B of 3. It means the same thing. So these are the parameters which we have assigned. This here C in is equal to 0 can also mean this is also equal to B in, and this is also equal to B of 0. That is what we are going to take now. So this is clear. So next, how can we convert this circuit to a circuit or to a logic which can implement both parallel adder, which can perform both addition as well as subtraction. Now to implement that, what we are going to do is we should use a XOR gate. So we'll see how, I'll explain how the logic works. We'll use an XOR gate over here. Okay. To this, one input to the XOR gate will be your C in bit. One input to your XOR gate will be your C in bit. Okay. So C in over here, one input. The other input to your XOR gate is B. So other input to your XOR gate is B. Now if you see our previous example where we converted, in the previous example where we converted 4-bit adder circuit into 3-bit adder circuit into subtractor circuit, what happened over there is we gave a NOT gate over here. So that NOT gate was giving you the adder operation. Now what am I doing? I'm using a XOR gate over here, and the output of this XOR gate is given to B. Exactly, B. Now will the logic work? Let us see. See, if I draw this, if I just check the logic gate. See what is my, it was initially, if it was A of 0 plus B, it is A plus B plus C in, right? Now if I give C in is equal to 0. Now if I give C in is equal to 0, A will be as it is. It won't change. Whatever you give to the value, A will be as it is. Whatever value you give to B, what happens to B? B will take, so B value will be equal to B XOR C in. Now B XOR C in, suppose B is 0. And if I want to perform addition, if it is addition, what should be our C in? According to our logic, if it is addition, C in should be equal to 0. So what will be the new value? 0 plus 0 will be 0, which is nothing but the old B value. But same thing, B is equal to, if it is a subtraction, what should be your value, B value? B should take the 2's complement value. So B will be equal to B XOR C in. And our new C in value will be, what should be our C in value as per a logic for adder getting converted into subtractor circuit? C in should be equal to 1. So 1 XOR 1. This is not plus, this is XOR operation. So 0 XOR 1 will be equal to what? 0 XOR 1 is equal to 1, which is nothing but the complement of B. If you can see, B complement of B. Actually, what should come out of the B? The complement should come out if it is a subtractor circuit. The true value should be available if it is an adder circuit. That means B should be reflected as it is if it is an adder circuit. The 1's complement of B should be available at this end if it is a subtractor circuit. That is what we are going to follow. So this is the logic. So this will work to act both as subtractor as well as adder. Then what about your carry? The other things will remain change. It will not change. So remain same. So now let us continue. So A will be connected as it is. And what about C in? C in value will be nothing but your C in value only, because C in is not changing. In 2's complement, it is complement of B plus C in. XOR gate is performing the complement if Cin is equal to 1. XOR gate is giving the real value if Cin is equal to 0. So complement, now we can write it as it is. This will also not change. So this is a value. Let me repeat it. So here I have C out of the first full adder, which is nothing but C of 1. C of 1 goes as the input to the second full adder, which is C of 1 over here. Now, the output of the second full adder goes as the carry input to the third full adder, and I get the final output. This part is clear. Now, wherever I have B, I have given an XOR. Now, for this B also, I need an XOR. For this B also, I need an XOR. My real work was with this input. What did we tell? When this input is 0, it will perform addition. When this input is 1, it will perform subtraction. So the other input to this XOR should be this one. So there was a small correction. The other input was this one. You should be very careful with this connection. Now, what is 5 plus 3? 5 plus 3 is 5 is 1. 0, 1, correct? And this is 0, 1, 1. So 0, 1, and 1. Cin, we should keep it as 0. So what is the output? Output is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. And the last one carry out will be 1. This is correct. So now if you see for subtraction, what is subtraction? What is subtraction? Subtraction is 5 minus 3, which is equal to 5 plus of minus 3. Now for subtraction, what did I tell you we should do? This carry should only change to 1. Then it will perform subtraction. What is 5 minus 3? 5 minus 3 is nothing but 2. So what is the binary value of 2? It is 0, 1, 0. So we can see it is 0, 1, and 0 with no borrowout. Because when we do 2's complement subtraction, we will be getting one borrow as we discussed previously. So 2's complement subtraction, 5 will be 101, 3 will be 011. So you have to convert it into 2's complement number, which is nothing but 100 plus 1, or it is 101. Now next, what did we do in 2's complement subtraction? It was 101 plus 101, which was equal to 10010. So it is 1010. So here I got 010. So you can see 010 with carry out of 1. So that carry out only is reflected over here. See, I got this carry out, which is nothing but this part over here in the circuit. So if you take another example, for addition. So let me take one more example for addition. Say it is, since it is 3 bit, so 7 plus 2 is what? 7 plus 2 is what? 9. So 9 will be equal to, in binary, 1001. Okay, so what is 7 now? 7 is equal to 111. What is 2? It is 010. So let us see. So our solution will be 00001 with carry out of 1. So carry out of 1 I am getting. So this is our carry out. So now what I should do? I should check it. So A1 is 1, A0 is 1, A1 is 1, A2 is 1. This is also 1, this is also 1. What about the next number? It is 0. So B0 is 0. B0 means last. You should take the LSB first. B1 is 1. B2 is 0. And what I should do? Addition. So if it is addition, what should happen to the Cin? Cin should be equal to 0. So what is the solution? 0, 0, 1 with borrow. With your carry out. So this is an example for parallel adder and subtractor. Now we'll implement parallel adder and subtractor unit using Verilog modeling style, Verilog coding using gate level model or structural model. So I will write FS, full subtractor, parallel adder come subtractor. So here no need to change anything. Finish. So new source, right click, new source, Verilog module, full subtract, parallel adder subtractor. So I've taken both. Now what is the size of this? What are the inputs I have? I have A comma B as the input, which is a bus, which is of the data size 2 down to 0, 3, right? 0, 1 and 2, 3 bit only we will do. One more input is the C in and B in, both are same. So I'll give a common name as C in, which is also equal to B in. Now I have sum. What is sum? Sum or difference. So sum or difference, it is output. Again, what is the size? This is 2 down to 0. Then I have C out, which is also equal to borrow out, I told. So I can give output. Finish. So this is the code for the parallel adder and subtractor, what I have written. So now I'm checking the syntax. Let us check the syntax. It is a good practice to write all the assignment statements at the end. So I've written all the assignment statements at the end. Now simulation, we don't have any errors. Check syntax completed successfully. Let us view the RTL schematic. Sometimes we will also analyze this RTL report. As of now, we are not analyzing, but sometimes it is good to analyze RTL report. You'll get what are the inputs, outputs, power consumed, what are the gates you have used, everything you'll get in the RTL report. So now I have this full subtractor. That is what is our module name. A is 3-bit, B is 3-bit. One input C in, S is 3-bit, C out. Now you can see this thick line. Vectors, vectored instances or the signals which are declared as vectors will have thicker lines compared to the other one. So let me view the technology schematic. So you'll have something like this. Now let us see the simulation. Let us see how we are going to simulate. So simulation. Click on simulation, add new source, right? New source. So it is Verilog test fixture, FS underscore test. So now inputs, all inputs are declared as registers. All outputs are declared as wires. This is also declared. So we need not worry about that, but you should write it. Here the system is generating it as declared. I have told you about two ways to write it. You can follow any two ways to write this. Now initializing the input hash 0 at 0th time input. I'll take A in is 0, B in is 0 and C in is 0. But what is the size of A? Is it single bit? It is not single bit. A is not single bit. A is 3-bit according to us. So 3 tick B. What is the example we took? 5 minus 3. So same example I'll take. 5. And B is 3-bit, right? So 3 tick B, 0, 1, 1. 5 minus 3, the result should be equal to 2. And this is for adder. One more example I'll take for adder. So I can take one more example for adder to check for addition. So I took one more example. That example was 7 minus 2. Again for adder, Cn should be equal to 0. Next we'll take for subtraction. So the timings you should change it, because after 5 time units. If I give a 4 over here now, from 5 to 4, 5 plus 4 up to 9 time units. So from time 5 to 9 time units, the second result will be there. Then from 9th time unit, the third result will be. So let me take for subtractor. Now if it is subtractor, let me take it as 5 minus 3. Subtractor, Cn should be made 1. So that also I have taken. So one more example also I can take. So let me take it as 4 to 3. 7 minus 3 I have taken. So again the Cn should be made equal to 1 because I am checking for subtractor. Whenever we are checking adder circuits, Cn should be equal to 0. So let me check the. Now we should write one more initial. So initial, you have to stop it, else the waveform, you'll get an indefinite waveform. So dollar, after how many time units, say hash 30 time units, 20, dollar stop. You can give any time of your choice. So there's one more initial I told for printf. I'm not going to see the printf statement for now, but you practice writing three initials. One to give the test case, one to define the test case, second to make sure that the waveform stops and it doesn't go to an indefinite sequence. And the third one should be an initial to get the outputs printed in the console window. So I'm not printing, there should be one more initial over here. So when we are checking, you should select the test bench program over here and then give check syntax. Sometimes what happens, your icon will be in implementation and you will select the main module and try to implement. You'll not get it. So it should always be in simulation and it should be the test bench program. Then only you'll get the test bench. You'll get the simulation results. So I'm simulating it. Now this is the main module what we have. I've checked the syntax. So let us go to the simulation test bench, go to behavioral check syntax, read on all, simulate behavioral model. So our behavioral model is simulated. And it is launched. Now if you come to the simulation, what is our test case? Last test case. Let me show what is the last test case. It is 7 minus 2. 7 minus 2 should be 5. Have we got that? 7 minus 2. We are not getting a 5 over here. That means we have an error in the program. So let us go to our program and check what is the error. Now what has happened in our program? We are not giving B as input to the full adder. We are giving BI as the input to the full adder, which is a signal we have declared. According to our logic, this is a signal we have declared. The output of the XOR is going as input to B. So this is the error. So let us save this. Check the syntax and rerun once again. Simulation. A simulator is launching. So this is the simulator. Now what is our value? 7 minus 2 is the last value. Let us see whether we have got that in the waveform. So we minimize it. So what is this? 7. 7 minus 2 is 5. We will have a C out which we should ignore. And now it is 5 minus 3 is a 2 is correct. 7 plus 2 is 9. So 9 is 1, 0, 0, 1 is correct. 1 carry out is depicted over here and the other one is also correct. So this is implementing a parallel adder and subtractor simultaneously using a single Boolean, single logic circuit. Thank you.